Hello, welcome to Let's Read the Books of Wyrmstooth. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading History of Wyrmstooth, which I found here in Fort Moonwatch. History of Wyrmstooth by Cassius Topellus. None can say exactly when, how, or by whom Wyrmstooth was first settled. History is, after all, at the brutal mercy of the elements and destructive political turmoil. However, by studying the remnants of the past, one may come to glean some understanding of the transpirations of an era long since forgotten. Mining Ventures. Today, most living at the mining settlement are employed into the service of the East Empire Company, which established a presence on the island around 3rd Era, 433, during the Oblivion Crisis. While this island may be rich in ore, corundum being its chief export, ebony is certainly not present in exorbitant quantities, and, as such, operations at Wyrmstooth never saw the same surge as was seen at Raven Rock. As far as gross capital is concerned, the Empire emphasized on numerous occasions a vested interest in maintaining EEC operations. But in contrast, on an almost yearly basis, the Empire routinely cuts the number of soldiers stationed at Fort Moonwatch, which now serves as the Empire's one and only point of defense against pirates, bandits, smugglers, and other ne'er-do-well individuals. Initially, Fort Valis was constructed to guard the southwestern flank of the island. Built around an old Nordic structure, it proved to be too far away from the mining settlement to be able to provide immediate assistance in the event of a bandit raid, and was subsequently abandoned. The cataclysm of Red Mountain during Fourth Era 5 saw a phenomenal disaster sweep across the northeastern shores of Tamriel. Wyrmstooth was spared much carnage, as most mining operations at the time were conducted on the western half of the island, and the glaciers to the east shielded much of the island from destruction. Cragwater Mine, however, sustained substantial damage. Given its low priority in terms of annual yield, the mine was never reclaimed by the EEC and has since fallen into the hands of local bandits. Wyrmstooth Barrow. The most notable feature standing prominently on the southeastern corner of the island is the ancient Nordic barrow, commonly referred to by the locals as simply Wyrmstooth Barrow. Its name in Nordic tongue escapes most of us, though some Nords claiming lineage to the families that built the barrow refer to it as Dwenjanar. It should be stated, though, that such lore is unverifiable without the ability to translate the carvings within the barrow. On that note, it should also be stated that one should be wary of the Draugr while traversing the corridors of the barrow in pursuit of scholarly interests. Wyrmstooth Barrow seems to have garnered some reputation among the adventuring cadre of Tamriel as a place to test one's mettle, and my personal experience supports this bold claim. Tamriel is home to many such dangerous crypts and ruins, and Wyrmstooth Barrow certainly stands amongst them as exemplary. While most Draugr appear to remain unresponsive to that which they do not consider a threat, a frail historian such as I would be quickly dispatched when exposed to a volley of superfluous force, so caution is of the utmost imperative. Tim Frost. Local Nords have also referred to an expansive, cavernous geological structure below the island simply as Dimfrost. Given the volcanic nature of this location, the presence of a magma chamber deep below the steam pools is plausible. Perhaps emptied by an eruption long ago, though volcanic activity on the island is far from dormant yet. While documented entrances into Dimfrost are sketchy, any such entrances from the surface are likely to disappear within years of their discovery due to geological instability and frequent earthquakes that hinder mining operations. Still, this has given some adventurers the opportunity to explore this seldom-seen world beneath the surface, albeit brief at that. Those that survived the trip and had made it back to the surface alive reported a cavern as deep as the sky is tall, and filled with luminous mushrooms and crystalline lakes. They also tell tales of encounters with pale-skinned folk of elvish appearance, but barbaric in demeanor, that live within extensive Dwemer ruins. Neither of these claims have yet to be verified through official scholarly channels, though future geological activity may yet yield opportunities to study this location with greater academic scrutiny. Certainly a significant Dwemer presence here would confound much of what we have come to know about the distribution of the Dwemer across Tamriel. Their purpose here on the island certainly remains a mystery to this day, one that certain organizations such as the Thalmor have expressed more than a casual interest in, despite these reports of Dwemer structures being little more than rumor and hearsay than documented academic information. Final Resting Place. Finally, it is important to mention the resting place of Volam, a wizard of ill repute, most infamously known for his successful transformation to lichdom, using secret techniques derived from the Slowed, an act and an alliance severely frowned upon by the Mage's Guild at the time, as were other necromantic rituals and practices. Volam, whose name in life was said to be Raiden Malan, took his alias from the language of the dragon priests of old, of that which I must express that I am not well versed in. The word Volam itself, however, is said to refer to darkness or shadows, apt given the type of magic the wizard dealt in. After several failed attempts by guild wizards, it is said that the Sigic Order intervened directly, defeating the Lich in open magical combat. As necromancers of such repute are rarely so readily dispatched, the remnants of his corpse, now all but scorched bones, were split up and scattered across the island so as to prevent a possible resurrection. Little details remain about his personal life or what ties he was rumored to have had with the famed necromancer Manamarco. What remains of his tomb can be found on the southwestern flank of the island close to the shore. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Wyrmstooth, History of Wyrmstooth.